Hey guys, I'm Tara with Tara Simon Studios, and today I'm going to be reviewing Kevin Olesola, who is doing a Marian Hill cover of the song Down. And it looks like he's going to be playing multiple instruments here. I know that he's also in Pentatonix, and I love him in that group as well, so I'm excited to review him. I've never heard him as a solo artist before. This is my first time listening, so I'm going to be giving you my candid, true reaction to what I'm seeing for the first time. Ooh, he's looping it. That's nice. Nice. Really cool cello.
You can be out, you get a show.
Really silky, smooth, texture in his voice.
So, baby, we should go and add some more. Are you down, diddy down, diddy down, diddy down, down, down?
His D's are very in the pocket of the rhythm. True form for a beatboxer, right?
Everywhere I look are people's hands thrown up in the air to have them dance. Come on, baby, catch me if you can. I know you don't have any other plans.
Are you down, really nice, diddy
down,
really
diddy down, diddy down, 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 diddy down, diddy
down. I love
down,
the texture of his voice. Down, it's very down, rich and silky at the same time.
Are you...
beatbox and not jam out to it too. Like, he has to do that. You have to move to it. So good. Wow. So good.
You know we can put them all to shame. Now isn't the time to play it safe. Isn't this the reason that you came? So, baby, don't you let it go to waste. Are you down, diddy down, diddy down, diddy down, down, down?
Nice.
Down, diddy down, diddy down, diddy down, down, down.
Very mellow.
Every single thing is gonna rise.
Nice, that's headway. Nice agility and flexibility there. Ooh, nice. Great pitch accuracy there. That's interesting. So for you guys out there, when you're doing head voice, there's actually different registers within a head voice that you can reach. So the first one, he was singing more of like a masky head voice. Are you down, diddy down, diddy, and then he switched right here to down. And you can hear the tone became a little bit more breathy because it was actually a little bit of a change in register there. He was needing to resonate in a different space in order to get that texture and quality and pitch of the note out, that higher one. So down, diddy, down, diddy, down, diddy, down, 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 or wherever he went afterwards. So just something to note, you don't have to feel mask or head voice or falsetto, whatever you want to call it. You don't have to feel that in the same place. Depending on the melody that you're doing or the note that you're hitting, it can be felt in different places within your head. Sometimes I feel, if I'm doing whistle, I feel it like in the top of my head. Sometimes if I'm hitting like a song, if I'm singing an opera song and I'm singing like an aria, I feel it right in my mask, right in the front of my nose where my eyes feel like they're about to bulge out, right? So feeling it, feeling tone and feeling resonance in different places is okay. It doesn't mean that it's wrong, okay? And he's manipulating that difference in placement to create a different sound and a different texture as he moves up the vocal range. Really cool. That's all in the same spot. Okay, so he looped the beatboxing part, super cool. And now he's adding percussion. I love that. That was so good. I think I'm gonna practice that at home and see if I can do it. He was classically trained on the cello, I can tell. Has to be. If he wasn't, I don't believe you. Nice slide up. Almost sounds like an electric guitar. It's crazy. I love that tension. So good. Stop real quick and say that one guy's making all of these sounds. I mean, yes, thanks to a loop, but what the heck? Love that part. My favorite. So he used that keyboard for one note, that little ding in the song. I was waiting for him to do something else. I was waiting for him to use the keyboard for something else, but he literally used it for one note. That's hilarious. Talk about multiplying your giftings, right? Talk about a Renaissance man of music who can play multiple instruments, is so multifaceted in his vocal production. Talk about the rhythmical patterns that he does when beatboxing, his little bloop 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 that he did, like a sonic kind of sound effect that he did, and then actually singing, which I didn't know he could do. I thought he was just beatboxer extraordinaire in pentatonic. So I've been schooled today. Wow, what a diverse talent. So that was a pleasure to watch. Thank you so much for recommending that to me. I really, really enjoyed that. It's important to be a triple threat in the music industry these days. I mean, think about how hireable this guy is, right? So if you're that person who is on the fence, maybe you're a good vocalist, but you're like on the fence about taking piano. One of my artists, one of my Broadway students, Lauren Lott, I've been trying to get her to take piano for years as a vocal student and saying, Lauren, like, it just makes you better. It makes you a better singer. It makes you more hireable. And it's been such a struggle to try to convince her. And I think I'm going to show her this video and say, hey, Kevin's doing it. He sounds awesome. Maybe you should too. But for those of you out there who are kind of on the fence about it, it is so beneficial to be able to play an instrument and sing. You're a better musician as a singer. You're a better singer as a musician. So I encourage you, if you're kind of on the fence or wondering, make the investment in yourself. You're worth it. Your talent's worth it. And the well-rounded nature of being an artist is worth it too. Whether it's me or someone else, it doesn't matter, but let's just talk about being a responsible and well-rounded, multifaceted artist. That's what we want, and that's what I hope for you as well. So I really liked him a lot. That was really enjoyable. So if you like what you've seen today, subscribe below. Our subscribers are amazing. Join the family. They're awesome. We love to comment back and forth. I read all of your comments and I comment back to as many as I possibly can. I'm up to like 1-2 in the morning till my thumbs are bleeding, writing you guys back on my phone. And there is an 8-week course that's available to you. If the link is below, that means it's live. You can click on that and check it out. It's based off of my singing methodology called Sing Smarter, Not Harder. And it's the foundation course. So this is for anybody from a beginner all the way up to advanced Broadway level singers like my student Lauren, who rely on this technique that I've developed to keep their voices in shape, to help them know where the sound is coming from, and to keep them singing 8 shows a week or more. So if that's you, if you're a beginner and want to learn, if you're someone who is saying, wow, I'm singing so much, but I'm singing too hard, and I feel like feeling like I have too much recovery time, like I need it and I shouldn't be needing that much, that course is for you. Let me help you. If you want individualized time, feel free to click on the link below for lessons as well. There's something there for you as well. I'm happy to help you, or one of my hand-trained coaches are also happy to help you at TSS. So whatever you need, we're happy to be a resource for you, especially when it comes to these awesome reaction videos. So keep the comments coming, guys, and I will see you on the next one.